From the car. How's everybody doing? I'm Oscar Blue for Border Network News and America's Voice News. God bless everybody that is watching. God bless my country of Mexico, my city of Tijuana, and God bless the United States of America. Let's thank God for giving us two legs, two arms, a mind that we can think, a heart that we can feel, and eyes that we can see. How's everybody doing? Hopefully you guys are doing good, and hopefully everybody's doing all right. It's raining over here in Tijuana, and I heard a video of Joe Biden being asked about the situation and the migrant crisis that is occurring right now in the borders. A photo is going viral as we have, have been broadcasting about the yesterday's protest. Of migrants going directly to the border of San Ysidro and kneeling down and praying for Joe Biden to give them an opportunity of migrating to the United States of America. After that, today in the morning, yesterday in the morning, Joe Biden was asked about the migrant crisis in the borders. And ultimately, it led to an answer that it leaves everybody, with uncertainty of what is going to happen in this migrant crisis that is occurring right now in our borders, provoked by statements and by ultimately declarations of Joe Biden saying that he was going to let in by the quantities of 300 after the 19th of February. What the hell happened? He responded, yes. A reporter asked, there's some comment right here that I am going to eliminate this person. It says, don't put down the USA, worry about yourself. What are you doing in my life, Aiden? Plain and easy. I'm not putting down the USA. When have I done that? When? Situation provoked by the President of the United States of America. What are you talking about? It's a situation that it was provoked by the United States of America. What are you talking about? By the President of the United States of America. I'm sorry. Who provoked this? Again, I will ask for everybody that is watching and for you that you just said this comment. Who provoked this? Do you know? Right now, migrants are outside of the port of entry of El Chaparral in the rain, because it's raining, as you can see. And they're waiting for an answer. They're waiting for an answer of Joe Biden. He was asked by the press. Thanks so much. Everybody saying you never put down the United States of America. I know. He was asked by the press if he knows about the migrant crisis. And he responded, yeah. That's all that he responded. That's all. There's people sleeping outside right now in the rain. Sleeping outside in the rain. Waiting for this man to give a statement on what the hell is going to happen. There's people waiting outside. Outside in the rain right now. Because this man released a statement saying, I am going to help the migrants and I'm going to create a better pathway for migrants. And he was asked with children. Yes, absolutely. Good morning, Rain. With children. And he was asked in particularly if there was a crisis stay with me on this live feed because I'm going to respond to this particular comment right now. He was asked if he knew about this migrant crisis. If he knew about this. And he just said, yeah. That's all that he said. I know what's going on. Shut up. Leave me alone. I'm over here in my White House. Just like they say, chilling like a villain. I'm over here at the White House. There's no crisis. What are you talking about? You're talking about no crisis. Stay with me on this live feed because it's raining, as you can see right now. It's raining. And a situation, I know that there's, and I will clarify this for people that are watching in English. I will say this to you. There is a migrant crisis right now. And ultimately we know, not only that, but we know that there's homeless in the United States of America. There's hundreds and thousands of homeless in the United States of America. Hundreds and thousands of homeless. And homeless has been, one of the problems of the United States that it has been growing. In LA, you can see Tent City, and it is horrible what is happening over there. And even people have said there's better tents that the migrants have that, there's better tents than migrants have than what homeless in the United States of America have. There's better tents. And I completely understand that, as I can tell you, there's a lot of homeless people in Mexico. That has nothing to do, that's another big problem that is provoked by dirty politicians and by corrupt politicians and parasites, that they get better the money for their pockets to implement programs for homeless people and for poor people or for people that are in critical and economical condition. That has nothing to do with the immigration. Absolutely nothing to do. That's a whole different topic. And priorities is the number one, it's a word that I have been saying since I started broadcasting, prioridades. Priorities is a word that these politicians have forgot about. Priorities. And I want you to stay with me right now on this live feed. Because I want you to look at something. I want you to look at something that is really bad. But he was asked, the president, the 46th president of the United States was asked about what is going on in the borders. Now that the homeless veterans, the homeless people in the United States of America and the homeless people in Mexico have nothing to do with the immigrant situation. And I will tell you why. Separate the two things, please. Because one has nothing to do with the other one. Absolutely nothing to do. Immigration is a whole different topic. And this thing that is happening right now at the borders, it is provoked not by China, not by Russia, not by Denmark, not by Germany, not by France. It is provoked by a statement that it was given by the 46th president of the United States of America, that is Joe Biden. Again, I will repeat myself for the 46,000th time. In the statement on the debates, with the debate of Donald Trump against Joe Biden, Joe Biden was emphatic. Every time he was completely emphatic on saying this, I will create a better pathway for migrants. That's a word that stays in my mind continuously, and it stays in my mind consistently Because I say he's going to create a better pathway for migrants. What kind of better pathway he's going to create? The ones that they created this horrible pathway for migrants, it is the globalists, the United Nations. I'm almost there. I'm almost there. Stay with me. It is the United Nations that created all of this. So this pathway that they're talking about so emphatically, I'm still waiting for it. As I have been doing broadcasts in the place of the migrants right now that they're camping out. And ultimately, you have seen how more than 150 children, more than 150 children are living right now in these horrible conditions. The subject is who provoked this and who's provoking this. And I am not saying it. Consistently, I've been interviewing migrants, which they, by their own mouth, they have been given statements and saying, yeah, he's lying. He's lying because he told us that he was gonna let in everyone. He did not say we will only be letting in MPPs, people with appointed court dates, people with this, people with that. No, he didn't say that. He said, and everybody's, you know, and the live feeds that I have done, they're justifying saying, Oscar, Joe Biden is a liar. He always has lied. I don't care about that, really. I don't care if he has lied in the past 20,000 times. I really don't care. What I care what is happening right now. And what is happening right now is that he provoked this situation, and nobody from the United Nations, nobody from the Commission of ACNUR, that is the Commission of Refugees, has come out and said something about this situation. Nobody. Nobody. And you got people right now sleeping outside in the rain in this horrible conditions, in this horrible situation. So don't come to me with this comment saying, why are you putting down the USA? Not putting down the USA. Absolutely and ultimately, that is not. No, hell no. What I'm saying is, who's gonna fix this? It is a problem that has been occurring for the longest of time now, since globalists created this globalist compact of immigration. Saludos, Carlos, hasta Mexicali. Saludos, cómo no, carnal. Por ahí nos vamos a andar dando una vuelta la siguiente semana por allá, por Mexicali, a transmitir sobre la frontera. Who provoked all of this? And I like to give people facts all the time. Video facts. Video facts. And this, you know, I'm not too far away, but this comment that just appeared on my live feed, I want you to answer me this. This right here. Where are the United Nations? And where is, ultimately, right now, Joe Biden? Where is he? Look at that. Look at that. I'm just gonna sit here. Look at all those people underneath the bridge. I will right now sit here right now. I'm gonna put it in park. I will park here. So I will focus on here, and I'm asking you a question. There's children right here. There's children, more than 150 children right there. Do you see the United Nations giving solutions to these people? Do you see somebody from the administration of the United States coming out and telling, this is the process that is going to happen? More than 1,500 migrants are right here stationed at this particular place. So that this goes for that comment. I love to prove with facts, man. I love to prove with video and facts. There's no crisis at the border, right? This is not a crisis. Migrants risking their lives through a third world class country like Mexico that is number one for cartel activity, number two for child trafficking, and number two for killings of women. There's no migrant crisis, right? It's raining outside right now, and there's no migrant crisis. Right? The children right here. Look at that kid on his stroller right there. So I wanted to just come here to show that comment. I was like, you know, might as well. I'm on my way. I might as well do it. How's everybody doing? I'm Oscar Blue for Border Network News and America's Voice News. I just heard a statement that, you know, practically a new administration from the United States government said that there's no crisis at the border. And there's nothing is going on. So I wanna, you know, prove to these people there's nothing going on, right? You see mainstream media right now, right here from Televisa, right here walking around. You see that? So there's nothing going on. Let me just take a little ride, man. Let's take a little ride right here. There's nothing going on, people. Everything is okay. So there's no migrant kids right here. There's no tents. Look at this. Nothing going on. Look at this kid, man. Look at that kid, man. Look at that. My God, man. Nothing going on, people. Everything's all right. Everything is okay. Look at this, man. There's nothing going on. Absolutely nothing going on. Sector of Health just arrived right here. This is good information right here. The Sector of Health has just arrived. There's nothing going on, people. Huh. So I just wanted to come here. It's raining, and I wanted to show everybody what a statement by saying, I'm going to create a better pathway for migrants. What is that statement provoked? Look at all these people waiting here outside underneath the bridge, man, in the cold. Look at all this. This is the statement by just saying, I'm going to create a better pathway. Nothing's going on. Everything's all right. Perfect. First couple of months in the immigration situation looks like this. First couple of months. Amazing, huh? Who's feeding them? There's nonprofit organizations that they're coming and they're helping them. This is why they went over there to protest. I did a video yesterday late at night at YouTube, and I suggest you guys go over there and watch it. I suggest you guys go over there and watch it, as that video explains what it happened in 2018 and practically explains what happened in 2018 with the desperation at a place that was called Benito Juarez. It was a baseball field where they were sleeping. Desperation led to a peaceful protest that it was thousands of migrants protesting through that bridge on the top that you see and running and trying to rush the border out of desperation. This is a time bomb, people. These migrants are right here. You see one t-shirt right there, Biden let us in. That t-shirt again. These migrants right here that are stationed peacefully, they went yesterday for a peaceful march. And they went to get or some kind of solution. Now, I want to ask you something. What do you think is going to happen if this continues for 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, right here, without no portable bathrooms, without no food, without nobody coming out from the U.S. government and giving statements or saying this is what is going to happen? What do you think is going to happen? You think these people are going to be staying here forever? No, it is a time bomb. And people are going to... They cut my live feed. I completely understand Facebook that they don't want me to broadcast this kind of stuff. But this is... They cut my live feed in the middle when I was saying that this is the provocation. You cannot... You know, I'm... Everybody's humanitarian and everybody knows that they have their own problems. But I was answering to a comment and saying, you know, no, nothing is going on. There's no crisis. And I'm watching right here how these people are sleeping on the outside of the plaza where they are hoping for the administration of Joe Biden to come out and give statements about the reality of if they are going to be accepted in the United States of America. Are you on YouTube? Yes, I'm Oscar Blue, and same name, Oscar L. Blue on YouTube. So this is something that at a particular moment, it is going to be this is desperation. Look at this, man. Look at this. And it's raining harder every moment. The most sad thing about this is that there's children right here. There's more than 150 children right here. Sleeping on this kind of conditions. Totalmente de acuerdo contigo, Omar. Ese es el problema que, o sea, están siendo utilizados, pobres, ¿no? Porque, pues, están siendo utilizados, están... prácticamente les mienten y les dicen que va a estar el acceso todo completo y la desesperación va a llegar a ese punto en el que van a tener que, pues van a, se van a querer cruzar así como lo que pasó en el 2018. Va a llegar un punto de desesperación. Look, these people are getting the water out of their tents, as you can see right there. We're live from Tijuana. And I just answer a question, you know, because people were saying like, oh, there's Joe Biden was asked if he knew about the crisis in the border. And he said something like, I don't know. Is there a crisis? So for everybody that is watching, this is, I don't know if this is a crisis or not, but it's provoked by saying, I'm going to create a better pathway for migrants. Is this a better pathway? I'm asking. This is a question that I'm asking you right now. Let me flip the camera. Is this a better pathway? I gotta give it to the nonprofits that they have been coming over here and providing food and providing clothing and blankets and all this kind of stuff. But, you know, is this a better pathway? On my human side, on my heart that is humanitarian, I would like to know if this is a better pathway. I'm a humanitarian for my people, also for my Mexican people, and always your country first. But is this a better pathway? Again, the question. Is this the planification that they were talking about, the new administration, with a pandemic? So, oh my God, every time and every moment, and again, it looks like 2018 all over again. It looks like the year 2018 all over again. You remember in 2018, they were not camping out at this particular place, but they had a hunger strike right here underneath the bridge. There's people wearing the Biden Let Us In. People in the middle of the bridge, as you can see. For me, this is not a better pathway. How's everybody doing? I'm Oscar Blue from Border Network News and America's Voice News. God bless everybody that is watching. Saludos a todos. Soy Oscar Blue para Border Network News y America's Voice News. Esto dice que es Joe Biden dijo que iba a crear un mejor camino para migrantes y este es el mejor camino. Qué barbaridad. Joe Biden just said that he was going to create a better pathway for migrants, and this is the better pathway. El presidente de los Estados Unidos está siendo cuestionado por migrantes en este momento. The president of the United States of America is being questioned by migrants right now at this particular moment. Y el presidente de los Estados Unidos dio declaraciones de que iba a crear un mejor camino y que iba a dejar entrar a todos, sin excepción. And the president of the United States gave statements saying that he was going to let in everybody without no exception. Y el día de hoy, en este día lluvioso, con más de 150 niños ahí y más de mil y tantos migrantes, vemos su camino que él supuestamente está creando. And today, with this rain and more than 150 children right there at this camp, we are seeing the better pathway that he is creating. Nosotros sabemos que este problema, señores, no es un problema que se generó por nuestro país. Nosotros no queríamos este problema. We know that this problem, our country, the countrymen of Mexico, the Mexicans, we did not generate this problem. Este problema lo generaron con este Pacto Mundial de Migración que fue firmado, ratificado de nuevo en el 2018 por Andrés Manuel López Obrador y Marcelo Ebrard. This problem was generated first in Mexico after re-signing again the Globalist Compact of Immigration in 2018. Y después de eso, poniendo como prioridad la situación migratoria en vez de la situación de pobreza de nuestro país. And from there, putting as a priority the migrant situation instead of the poverty in our country. Después de eso, se pone dura la cosa por 3 años consecutivos en la situación migratoria. After that, you know, the things started getting really bad with the migrant situation across our countries, Mexico and the United States. El tráfico de niños fue enorme, lo que ha estado sucediendo en estos pasados meses. The enormous child trafficking that has been occurring in these past months has been horrible. Más de 34,000 niños traficados en la caravana migrante desde el 2018 y más de 5,700 en este mes de enero. Niños no acompañados han llegado a la ciudad Juárez. More than 34,000 kids have been trafficked in the caravan since 2018 and more than 5,700 unaccompanied children were registered on the month of January alone in 2021 that they arrived to the border of El Paso in Juárez. Y ahora vemos un presidente que en un debate dijo, voy a crear un mejor camino para migrantes para poder ayudarlos. And now we look at a president that has just said, you know, I'm creating a better pathway for migrants so we can help them migrate to the United States. El problema aquí es de que al momento de tú provocar estas declaraciones, provocas caravanas, provocas que la gente se ilusione y llegue este momento de esperanza. The problem with this statement is that you provoke hope and you provoked not only that, you provoke caravans and you provoke people to come together and try to push the narrative of immigration immediately. Al parecer, la administración, esta nueva administración, no sabe absolutamente lo que ha estado sucediendo en la situación migratoria por más de tres años. Apparently, this new administration does not know what this immigration situation has been happening in our country, in Mexico, and in our borders. No saben que tenemos más de 20,000 migrantes en Tijuana, en el estado de Baja California. They don't know that we have more than 20,000 migrants that they are waiting to cross to the United States of America. More than 20,000 in our state of Baja. No saben que son más de 80,000 alrededor de todas las fronteras. They don't know that they are more than 80,000 people that they are waiting for the political and refugee asylum across the borders. No saben que hay más de 20,000 que están esperando entre Tapachula y Guatemala. They don't know that there's more than 20,000 waiting on the borders of Tapachula and Guatemala. Y no saben que la crisis en el Triángulo de Centroamérica migratoria es grandísima y son más de 40,000 que están esperando. And they don't know that there is a crisis in Central America, in the Triangle of Central America, that more than 40,000 are waiting to migrate. No solamente eso, no sabe que la situación es muy crítica en nuestro país con este presidente Andrés Manuel López Obrador que tiene ideas comunistas. And ultimately, the new administration from the United States does not know of these complications with this new administration that it has, this new administration in Mexico that it has a communist ideologies. Al parecer, la administración nueva de los Estados Unidos no sabe absolutamente de la enorme violencia y delincuencia que existe en nuestro país y la actividad de cartel. Apparently, the new administration of the United States does not know of the high activity of cartel, violence and delinquency, and killings and assassinations of women. Al parecer, no saben que somos el número uno por actividad de cartel, número dos por tráfico de niños, número dos por asesinatos a mujeres a nivel Latinoamérica. Apparently, the new administration does not know that Mexico is number one for cartel activity, number two for killings of women, and number two for trafficking of children. Y aparentemente no se han fijado que México está pasando por una situación horrible en términos de pobreza, en términos de la pandemia. And apparently the country, the new administration of the United States of America, does not know that Mexico is going through a really serious poverty situation. And not only that, that they're going through a pandemic situation that is horrible. Somos el número uno por muertes de tasa de mortalidad de COVID ahorita en estos momentos y muertes de enfermeros y doctores en nivel Latinoamérica. We're number one right now in our continent of America for deaths of COVID and also for deaths of doctors and nurses. El problema que más duele, señores, acerca de todo esto, the problem that really hurts about all of this, son los niños. Que el lado humano, desgraciadamente, es lo que más duele. The problem right here is the kids. That, you know, with the human side, you know, you see, it hurts, you know, and it is the responsibility of the parent that they're bringing their kids over here. Y nosotros sabemos que es la responsabilidad del padre y los padres de familia que traen a sus hijos hacia acá. Pero verlos pasar por estos momentos, ver pasar a niños por estos momentos es terriblemente doloroso. You know, to see kids going through these kind of situations, it hurts. And to see our also Mexican kids on the streets without no food, without no shelter, without nothing, it hurts. Y estas situaciones son provocadas por declaraciones que quieres dar esperanza hacia otros países de otras naciones. And this, you know, situations are provoked by statements that you're trying to give hope to other people in other countries. Después de dar declaraciones y después de dar este tipo going through a church, después de dar declaraciones y después de dar este tipo de otra vez declaraciones, la gente está esperando que salgan a decir algo. You know, after giving statements and after giving all these declarations, people are waiting outside for somebody from the U.S. government to come out. Y definitivamente no sabemos hasta qué grado o hasta dónde va a llegar. And we basically, we don't know until what point is going to get this. Lo único que sí les digo es que esto es una bomba de tiempo en lo cual la desesperación va a llegar y va a provocar otro problema. The only thing that I can say to you guys, this is a question of time for another problem to happen and another problem to occur. Y mientras el gobierno de los Estados Unidos no diga absolutamente nada, and in the meantime that the government of the United States of America does not say anything, esta situación se va a poner cada día peor. This situation is going to get worse and worse and worse. Y es un problema que básicamente nosotros lo hemos estado viendo por más de 3 años. And it's a problem that we have seen for more than 3 years. And it's a problem that it hasn't been controlled for more than 3 years. Y ha sido un problema que no lo han controlado ya por más de 3 años. Y Tijuana ha sido una de las fronteras más afectadas por el flujo migratorio. And Tijuana has been one of the borders that has been affected more for this enormous influx of migrants. El tráfico de niños es una realidad. The enormous child trafficking is a reality. God bless you all. It's sad to see these kind of problems, man. Dios me los bendiga a todos, y es triste ver todo esto, este tipo de problemas. Porque verdaderamente nosotros sabemos como mexicanos que la situación migratoria no es uno de nuestros problemas prioritarios, ¿no? We know that the immigrant situation and the migrant situation is not a priority as a Mexican. Tenemos muchísimos problemas más, que son la actividad de cartel, la violencia, la delincuencia, la corrupción. We have more problems to worry about as Mexicans. We have the cartel activity, the violence and the delinquency, the assassinations, the kidnappings, and also, you know, the corruption that is occurring in our country, has been occurring for a long time. Y échale otro problema más como es esta situación migratoria en las fronteras, ¿no? And bring another situation that is problematic like this, that is, you know, the migrant situation. Espero, I hope, que algún... alguna persona ya salga y de alguien y de declaraciones. I hope that somebody from the government of the United States comes out and gives statements and fix this y arregle esto, porque esto es una bomba de tiempo. Va a explotar. Because this is a question of time. Something not good is going to come out of this. Y yo espero que todo se resuelva con paz y con soluciones concretas. And I'm hoping that everything has been resolved with peace and with concrete solutions. Si los van a dejar pasar, díganles ya. Son 3 años lidiando con este problema. Si los van a dejar pasar, díganles. Si no los van a dejar pasar, díganles también. If you're going to let them pass, tell them. If you're not going to let them pass, just tell them also. Pero por favor, no estén haciendo esto y poniéndolos en ese lugar, dejándolos por días, meses ahí, que también ocasiona que negocios y los taxistas les ocasione una baja a su trabajo y afecte los negocios capitalistas alrededor. Also, you know, don't take that long because you're affecting local businesses. and you're affecting the taxi drivers, and you're affecting people that they work near that area. Esperamos soluciones. We are hoping for solutions. The sector of health just arrived. El sector salud ya arribó ahí. Y creo que fueron enviados para prácticamente ayudar. And, you know, they were sent there to practically help the situation to get resolved. But this is something that is a responsibility of the United States government right now. Esta es una responsabilidad del gobierno de los Estados Unidos en estos momentos. I'm calling it like it is. Porque si el presidente de los Estados Unidos no hubiera abierto la boca en haber dicho que va a crear un mejor camino para migrantes, esto no hubiese sucedido. Personas pasando un mal momento afuera. Because this problem was provoked by a person opening up his mouth and saying that he was going to create a better pathway for migrants. And right now you have people outside waiting for him to come out and give a statement. Not the president, but somebody from the government of the United States. Señores, ha sido un placer hablar con ustedes. People, has been a pleasure to talk to you guys. I don't do live feeds that much, speaking Spanish and English fluently. Casi no hago videos hablando español y inglés y al mismo tiempo traducirlos. Creo que los voy a empezar a hacer más seguido. I believe that I'm going to start doing videos like this, speaking Spanish and speaking English at the same time, immediately translating. Inmediatamente traduciendo. Lo voy a hacer más videos traduciendo inmediatamente el inglés y el español. So the audience can interact and we can have all kinds of, you know, interaction with, you know, Mexican citizens and also U.S. citizens. Para que también haya mucha interacción entre ciudadanos también de México y gente que no sabe hablar el lenguaje del inglés y poder estar interactuando entre nosotros. Soy un locutor y reportero binacional. I'm a binational reporter and broadcaster. Y se me hace justo que tengamos que hacerlo en dos lenguajes. And I believe that it's fair that I need to start doing my broadcast regarding this particular situation in both languages at the same time. Creo que necesitamos hacer esto justo porque está afectando nuestra ciudad de Tijuana, Baja California, y está afectando la ciudad de San Diego. And I believe that it's fair that we do broadcasts in two languages at the same time because it is affecting not only the Tijuana citizens, but it's affecting also the San Diego citizens in the United States of America. Creo que es importante que entre todos arreglemos esta situación y unamos fuerzas para luchar en contra de esta agenda globalista. I believe that right now it is a particular moment to unite and to fight against this globalist agenda. Y creo que es importante que todos nosotros estemos unidos para poner la prioridad de la pobreza en nuestro país y de cada de su país y poner las dificultades al lado y unir primero la prioridad. And I believe that this is about priorities, to always put your country first, fix our country so we can help other countries, because if we are, it's poverty, bringing poverty over poverty, it is a communist agenda. Es una agenda comunista, traer pobreza a pobreza. Socialismo, traer pobreza a pobreza y solamente crear una clase social. Señores, ha sido un placer hablar con ustedes. It has been a pleasure, people, it has been a pleasure talking to you guys. Sigan a mi compañero Real Anthony Agüero. Lo pueden seguir en sus plataformas de YouTube, Facebook, Parler, Orbeez. Y también lo pueden seguir en su canal de Telegram. You can follow my partner Real Anthony Agüero at Orbeez, Telegram, Facebook, YouTube, and Parler. Y también me pueden seguir a mí en mi canal de YouTube como Oscar Blue. Acabo de hacer un video muy bueno en comparativa de lo que sucedió en el 2018 y lo que está sucediendo ahora. Follow me also at YouTube. I just did a Spanish video, really good, and comparing what happened in 2018 and comparing to what is happening right now. También me pueden seguir en Facebook en mi página de figura pública como Oscar L. Blue. And also you can follow me on Facebook as Oscar L. Blue. Give it a like and share. Denle like y compartan. Y también pueden seguirme en mi canal de Telegram como Oscar L. Blue. And also you can follow me in my channel at Telegram as Oscar L. Blue. Ha sido un placer hablar con ustedes. It has been a pleasure talking to you guys. Recuerden, viva México, y por siempre México. And like we always say, peace and love, and always your country first. Paz y bien, porque su país es primero. Saludos.